What is up, YouTube? Welcome back to another video. As you guys can see, we are starting a new Zero to Hero. Now, I know I made a poll, right, about would you guys want me to go into Delve? I've decided to hold off on that. The reason why I decided to hold off on that, because quite frankly, I'll be honest, I am getting tired of the League, and I'm getting to that point where I'm getting burnt out and really don't want to play. Therefore, I do not want to have to work on the Blight and really not put my all into it. You guys deserve a really, really, really good series in terms of the Delve. I'm going to do something quite smaller for the rest of the League. We will be doing a Freezing Pulse Ice Bear Totems. I want to make this build be able to delete bosses really fast. That is the plan for this Zero to Hero, is to build up a bosser and being able to just delete Maven, Uber Maven, Uber Cyrus, all of the Uber fights, the regular fights, and really just showing the loot. I feel like this is going to be a lot smaller scope than to be doing an entire Delve series. And on top of that, I want to be able to show you guys a ton more when it comes down to that Delve series. That Delve series is going to be very fun. I'm going to go ahead and hold off on that until next League. That being said, we have a lot to do in terms of this build. And we got to get through the campaign. You know, as you guys can see, my stash is empty. The only stuff that's not empty, obviously, is like maps, flask, gems. They don't really matter too much, so that's the reason why I don't empty them. But the Blight tab is all empty, the Fossil tab, the Essences, Fragment tab is all empty. So everything is pretty much empty and ready to go. So that being said, we're going to go ahead and get this Freezing Pulse Ice Bear Totems off the ground. First things first is we cannot swap into Totems until at least Third Ascendancy. So we're going to have to get to Third Ascendancy with stuff like Selfcast or Ice Bear. We shouldn't have much of an issue at all in terms of the campaign. Let's go ahead and just get into the grind and see what we get ourselves into. Not like I haven't done this before. Hey, Alps.
Drink deeply from God's chalice, for the faithful will never find it empty.
The flame of her faith.
Another chaos! Rich chaos.
I
of the Chaos.
May a new dawn arise.
Campaign done. Alright, YouTube, we are now finished with the campaign. Now that we are done, we are going to be progressing the build now into the mapping stage. We do have a ton of work that we need to do progressing the build and making it so it can kill all bosses. We did happen to hit 5 chaos out of the campaign, which to get a little starter gear. The first thing we need to go for is the Annihilating Light, so that will triple our damage, but we will need to make up for the resistances that we will be losing. And then once we do get the Annihilating Light, we'll be working towards getting more of the Six Link and the Heat Shiver. Now, we do have, once again, a ton of work to do. This is going to take a lot of time in terms of getting this build up and running, being able to kill bosses. Once we are able to kill bosses, we are going to focus on, in terms of money, will be essences. We really, 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 really should be killing essences, get a lot of currency, getting into the T16s, killing essences. That being said, we will be jumping into the bosses. Once we are able to blow up the bosses instantly, that will take, it all depends how fast we get into T16 essences. If we can get into T16 essences quickly, then we will be fine. It shouldn't take us a lot at all to get there, but we just never know. Early on, we're just pretty much just going to be farming maps. We're going to be focusing on leveling, trying to hit at least 90 to 95. But anyway, let's do our ascendancies and let's get into the grind. Hope you guys enjoy.
Stop it. Get some help.
Campaign is done. You know I'm happy now.
The trap. It is inescapable.
Okay, so we're gonna pick this up early. This will help us out with damage. Divine, let's go. Drawing box, gotta love him. Hey, this is an actual pretty decent. I would take it. Yeah, a divine. Let's go. And this is why we expected the ritual right here. Here we go. Time to start dealing triple damage. some res boots. Alright, YouTube, it is time to end off the video. We have got a lot done in this one. You know, obviously this is the beginning, this is the start. I am extremely excited to see how this build performs. Apparently, it can really get a lot of DPS and it can one-shot bosses like off the face of the earth. And that is where we are headed. Tomorrow, we will start doing essence farming. We will start doing general T16 essence farming. We'll start buying scarabs and stuff and start really making a ton of currency that way. I tried to do harvest, but it looks like I'm gonna need to buy duplicate scarabs, but I don't know if it's even worth it to buy the duplicate scarab at this point because we are doing a ton of damage and we might even be able to do T16 essences already because our damage is so high. You know, as I said before, we are playing Freezing Pulse, Ice Spirit, Totems. I'll just go over some of the pieces of gear that we already have. It's not the greatest. Bear in mind, this is the first video. Now, we did buy a 60% reduced elemental resistances, Annihilating Light. We still have to work on our resistances. They are still quite low. You know, we're just capped in cold, but we still have to work on our lightning res and our fire res. These will come from other pieces of gear also. Our first divine, we bought a soul mantle. Obviously, soul mantle is best in slot in terms of bossing totem builds, like freezing pulse ice spirit totems. It just gives us the level 20 spell totems, and it makes it so we can use multiple totems, which is huge. Now, the heat shiver, it gives us extra damage, you know, against frozen enemies, and then the 1% chill effect on enemy too. All the other pieces of gear is pretty bad. This one is pretty bad. We need to get a full res ring, and then we need to get an anathema ring on the other one. Our amulet is also another piece that we need to get res, but later on down the line, we'll be getting plus one all spells, plus one all code skill gems, so we can have plus two, which will, you know, boost our damage up even higher. But for right now, we need the dexterity and we need the resistances. But this is definitely going to get upgraded in the due time. Our gloves, you know, obviously just res in general. We will change this out very, very soon. This will probably be one of the first upgrades that we do because we need to get a ton of res on the gloves. And the same thing with the belt. We got to get a ton of res. And same thing with the boots. But we bought these boots. These boots aren't bad at all. But these boots, on the other hand, we can use the dexterity because of the sniper's mark. We need to get that leveled a bit. But, you know, for right now, this will do. Gives us some good res, so we'll keep it. Flask, we need to work on our flask. I'll work on that in the next episode. This episode was really just trying to get a good starting ground and get, you know, all of the gear to the point where we can actually run and actually, you know, do essences. Because, like, the next episode, we will 100% be going hard with essences. Essences will make us a ton of money. And this build is going to be really good at killing essences because it's a bossing build. Let's go ahead and look at the atlas. This is the atlas that we've been using, you know, with ritual and then harvest. Now, what I want to do is go ahead and spec out of harvest and start specking into essences. The ritual, on the other hand, I don't know if I'm going to keep ritual in. You know, it's been really nice to get the divines and stuff out of it, but I just don't know if I want to keep it. I might move straight into getting, like, boss drops and stuff. That might be the play, is to just go straight into boss drops. But we will have to see. If you have any suggestions as a bossing build that is really good with essences, comment it down. We will do some testing and we will go from there. But for right now, I am set on essences and I am set on destructive play. And I am set on having it so the destructive play gives us extra boss map drops like Elder, Shaper, Conqueror maps and stuff like that. But in due time, we will definitely have to see in the long run. Other than that, that is our beginning. You know, I hope you guys really enjoyed this. It's really going to be a lot more chill for me. Anyway, hit that like, hit that subscribe button. Subscribe. Catch you guys in the next video.